Welcome to Franka Emeka. In today's video, we are going to answer the question how to register and synchronize your robot to Franka World. In order to do that, we need two things. Of course, our robot and also our laptop here, which is connected to the robot. And before we start the registration, we of course have to connect to the robot. We do so by typing robot.franka.de into our browser, and we are automatically connected to the startup visit here. The first tab here, the network tab, we can usually just accept. We can change these settings whenever we want to at a later stage. And in the second step, we already arrive at the object of interest here today, because this is the registration to Franka World. One word to the registration before we go into the details. The good news is you won't have to do the Franka World registrations yourself in most cases, because Franka Emeka will register the robot into your account for you whenever you purchase a robot through us directly. However, there are some scenarios where you still have to perform these steps. So if you have already got your robot registered, I will let you know later at which step the process will become relevant for you again. Before we start the process though, I want to say a few things about Franka World in general. Franka World, we can access via the URL franka.world. And in this case, I'm automatically forwarded to the hub. Usually you have to log in to your user account for your individual person here. That is already the critical thing about Franka World. There is users and there is accounts, and the concept can be a bit confusing. So I'm trying to make it clear here now. There is users. Users are individual persons, personal accounts. And then there is accounts, which are organizations, entities. So it could be a company, it could be a university, any sort of organization. And any user can have access to a certain number of accounts, and also accounts can again have several users that are connected to them. Meaning, as a user, I can have access to multiple accounts, which could be, as a practical example, the multiple accounts for different departments within my company, if that was something that was to exist. Or on the other side, as a company account, I can of course have multiple employees that have their users connected to this one account. That is the concept of users and of accounts. The most important tab in Franka World is the Manage tab. In the inventory, you can see your software licenses that you have bought on top of the standard packages that come with the robot. So the basic app package or the FCI license for the researcher. Now, in order to get our robot into this list here, we really need to perform the registration steps now. The registration is always a three-step process. We download the registration file onto our laptop, which is what the first step here does. We simply click on it and we can see that the registration file has been saved into our downloads folder. Then we go to the registration page in Franka World simply by clicking this link on the second step. And we can see we are automatically forwarded to the registration page. And here we can now upload the file that we have just downloaded. So we select the registration file, open it, and we can already see the serial number of the robot or the robot master controller that we want to register, and can select in which account we want to register it. In most cases, you will only have a single account here available. In my case, I have two different accounts that I can select. I want to register this robot to the Franka Academy account and therefore select Franka Academy. Simply by clicking register now, the robot will be linked to this account and will then show up in our manage page. And as we can see, the robot has been successfully registered and now shows up in the device list, and we automatically forward it to it. I can select the robot now, and actually see what is going on the system. I can do a few things right now already. I can give it a name. This will be the Franka Academy robot, which is located in the Franka Academy. Very simple. I apply that. And now that this has been applied, I can also synchronize the software. This is relevant so that the robot actually gets feedback about the successful registration. In the same step, I also want to already install the additional software package that I have down here. As you can see, the standard is already installed, but I can add additional software simply by selecting it in this list here. If I have more software available, it will show up below this tab. I click apply and confirm it, and now the software licenses are handed over to the robot for Franka World, and we can synchronize it on the system. Now that all the software has been assigned to the robot, we need to synchronize it. In order to synchronize the robot, I select the Synchronize button, and here I can now download the update file. This is the file that we then upload to the robot again in order to tell the robot about its identity and the changes and software that needs to be installed. I select download, and the file is being generated. Depending on how much software we are already installing, this can take a few seconds. We can see the download has been successful, and therefore the last thing we have to do is go back to the robot, to the third step where we synchronize the robot. Now, as I said earlier, if the robot has already been registered for you, this is the step where you actually have to do something again. So the manual registration and the registering into the account has been done for you, but you still have to synchronize the robot and upload the first update file. In order to do so, we click upload, select the update file, open it. Now we can here see which changes will be performed, so we can actually monitor what the robot will do after we apply these changes, which we of course want to do. And for the update of the feature files that will be installed with that, always a reboot is necessary. We select yes and click apply and reboot. Now that the system has been rebooted, we again at the first step of the registration, which we can confirm again. And now back at the second step, we can actually see that the changes that we have made with the registrations have actually been applied. I can see that the robot is now registered to the correct Franka Academy account. And the robot offers me this new option here, which is report the robot status back to Franka World. That is important so that Franka World also knows that the software that we planned on installing has been successfully installed. I select download again, and I upload that file again to Franka World. This can be done here on the same page of the synchronization. I simply select it. Now select my status file and upload that to Franka World. And as we can see, everything is up to date now. The system has been successfully synchronized. Franka World and the robot know exactly what is happening, and therefore we are done with our step that we wanted to achieve here today. We can therefore click next, give a username and a password, we confirm the end effector settings, and now for the first time we'll be redirected to desk, and we can see all the software that we planned on installing is actually installed on the robot. So we have the Franka Amica app package, the basic app package, and we also have the Roboception apps installed on the robot just as we had planned. Also in the settings, we can go back to the Franka World tab and see the status of the system again. Now, one thing worth mentioning is the connection status. If you connect your robot to the internet, it will tell you that the connection is online and the robot will transfer files for you automatically. If you do that, you will not have to download and upload files anymore. The robot will automatically get these files, and all you have to do is confirm and apply these changes. So it makes the process considerably easier for you, but in the background, the mechanisms at work are exactly the same. And if we go back to Franka World and we select our inventory tab, we can now actually see that the software that we have assigned to the robot is also blocked now, so you can no longer install it on other robots because it is now officially assigned to the robot that we have here right now. Thank you very much, and I hope you enjoy working with your robot.